In this video, we're going to go through how to set up a new company in QuickBooks Point of Sale. So from the File menu, I'm going to choose Company Operations, and then I'm going to choose to Create New Company. I'm going to click Next. It's going to prompt me to enter a new company name, so I'm going to say My New Store. And I'm setting up the headquarters store right now, but of course if you'd already set up your headquarters and you were setting up a remote store, then you would enter whatever that store number is here. And then I'm going to click Create. Now it's going to go through and create my new company. Of course, if you were just now installing QuickBooks Point of Sale, the setup interview, which we'll see in just a minute, is going to display once you've completed your installation. It's important to note that you can have a couple of different stores on the same computer if you'd like. It works just like QuickBooks does in that sense, that you can have multiple company files. If you have completely separate stores that sell completely different items to a completely separate customer base, for instance, you could set up separate company files for each one of those stores if needed. It's just going through the process here of activating my new company file, so we'll just give it a minute. And in just a few seconds, we'll see the setup interview displayed, where you will enter the information for your new store. So on here, I'm just going to enter the name of my new store, which is just called My New Store. If I had an address, then I would put in that address there as well. And this is going to be the same information that's going to show up on your sales receipt. So you would want to enter whatever information you want to show up on your sales receipt. If you have a website or if you want your store's phone number to show up, and then of course the receipt message. And I'm just going to click Next. It's going to come over to the sales receipt tab of the setup interview, and I'm going to choose yes that I do charge sales tax and what that rate is and who my sales tax vendor is. So I'm going to say State of Texas. I'm going to click Next. Now if you have an Intuit payments account for point of sale, you need to enter that information here. So you would just click yes, and then you would sign in to your Intuit payments account. Now if you already have a merchant account set up through your QuickBooks financial file, or if you have a GoPayments account, that is going to be separate from this. Once you have signed in, you can, of course, there are a couple of settings that you can edit. For instance, whether or not you want to allow cash back on debit transactions, what the maximum is you want to allow. If you want your customers to be able to include tips on credit card payments, of course, those tips would be processed with the sale. It doesn't work like a restaurant where you print out a receipt, the customer enters it, and then you go back in and adjust that tip amount. The customer would enter their tip amount, then the sale would be processed. You also have the option to automatically save and print a receipt when the transaction is approved. Do not allow manual transactions that fail card verification or adjust verification. If you are manually processing those credit cards and you have an adjust verification and it doesn't pass, then it won't allow the credit card to be processed. So I'm just going to click no because this is just a demo file. Then I'm going to click next. Of course, if you have a gift cards account set up with Intuit, then you would enter that Intuit gift card service number here as well, and then click verify. I'm going to click next. And then you would set up your hardware here. So if you're using a cash drawer or a pull display, you would set that up, and we go through the hardware setup in a different video as well. Then I'm just going to click next and I'm complete. So now I am ready to ring up my first sale. If you ever need to get back to that setup interview for any reason, you just come up here to file and go to setup interview and it will display it again. So if right now you don't have an Intuit payments account, for instance, and you want to go back in and set and enter that information once you've set it up, then you could just access the setup interview, go to payments, and enter that information there. I'm just going to click done for now, and that is how you set up a new company file.